I have been a bit worried about your little peanut head in winter. And with it coming up to Thanksgiving, I thought, well, I'm thankful for Jake. So I got you a present. I bought you a hat.
I have a hat. Oh my word.
It's both on brand for Thanksgiving. It's all I hoped for more.
What do I do with these? They're gonna chafe.
The network people for a long time have had all the fun, and now it's the runtime time. We've got a new API. Mm-hmm. It's the Web Smoothness API.
The Web Smoothness API? Please tell me it's just Web Smoothness true, and then the web is smooth.
Yes, no. The problem with that name kind of came up in the feedback from other vendors, and they sort of said, no, actually, it isn't that, because it's about measuring information. It's not about whether you're going to switch on smoothness, and it does sound like that, doesn't it? Mm. So it's actually been renamed to the Frame Timing API.
So it's going to give us similar to what we have for the Network Timing API, but for rendering.
Yeah, pretty much. So I think most people are used to the idea that they use sort of something like DevTools Timeline. They get all the records, like what's your frames per second, but that only applies to the machine they've got, right? Mm. You know, their desktop machine, their phone, whatever they've got on their desk or in their lab. This is about doing it at like an API level, so you can do it out in the wild. So all your users, you could in theory, you know, measure your transitions, your animations, your scrolling, all those things, and start to get a lot more data about what's going on in your main thread, what's going on in your compositor thread.
So you could use this to say, find out, in combination with like the user agent string, find out on a particular device that you've never even tested before, maybe you've never heard of before, but you have a major performance problem there.
You may not even do it through the UA string, because you can collect these bits of information and beacon them back to analytics or something like that, and it will do all that hard work of, you know, what device it was or where it was in the world and all those things. And you could just beacon back events and say, well, look, I think it was, you know, 60 frames a second. And then you can do the slice the data however makes sense to you, really.
So how can I tie these events back to the elements that are causing the problem? Does it tell me which element has been drawn, which element's being composited?
Nope. So the API is actually quite low level, I suppose. And it doesn't say what was going on, because the browser doesn't really know ahead of time what makes sense. So it just kind of goes, here's what the main thread was doing, here's what the compositor thread was doing, and you're responsible for sort of marking those areas yourself. And the spec itself is still in flux, right? So there's a lot of opportunity for developers and other vendors to kind of come back and bike shed it until we get to something that we think is, yeah, great. But at this point, hopefully, there's enough base information in there and in the API that people can start using it, start pulling data from the wild. Because we've heard so many times, oh, it's so hard, I do the measurement in my own machine, but I don't know if I've actually got runtime problems out in the wild. I know this for network because I've got web page test, I've got all these other APIs. So this is the first API we actually get for this. It's very exciting.
So giving feedback for this stuff, where is it? Is it W3? Is it, yes, GitHub?
W3. There's a W3C repo /frame-timing. Mm-hmm. And all the issues on there. And there's an explainer doc and the latest draft of the spec. So well worth checking out.
Real world analytics for rendering.
Woo!
So it's been conference season, so I've been doing a lot of traveling.
Yes.
Right. And so you've got your suitcase full of clean clothes. As the week goes on, they become soiled by your personal
soiled.
Wearing.
If it becomes soiled, that may be time to go and see somebody.
There's just general, you know, personal soilage.
Oh, let's move on.
So we were speaking about the you know, getting undressed. You do the, you know, the flick, oh, yeah. Catch. Where did it go?
Oh, into the suitcase.
Not with your clean clothes.
No, you unpack.
Ah, you monster.
No, you unpack them like a grown-up and you put them in the drawers.
They're folded in the drawers. That's where stuff gets forgotten. Your clothes, all nicely folded already, stay in the suitcase. So now I have a solution.
Yes.
I take with me a bin bag.
Ooh.
And that is where the dirty clothes go. And this has many advantages, right? Because you put them in there, it's a separate place for them to go, keeps them separate from the clean clothes, which are all nicely folded in the suitcase still. And it also locks the freshness in. But because it's airtight, which is a plus, at the end of the week becomes negative. Because you need to pack that away. And in order to get it back in the suitcase, you need to lose the excess air.
No.
And you go through a process that I've come to know as stinky bagpipes. You have to play a sad, sad song. Okay, Paul, I want to talk to you about font rendering.
Ooh.